Hello. Recall in a previous video, we created an observable model class that we called Shannon's Theorem Model. And also recall, a model is responsible for holding the data to our data-driven application. And in the case of Shannon's Theorem Calculator, our model holds values for the bandwidth, signal-to-noise ratio, and the maximum data rate. Recall at the end of the class, we added a magical method, a special method, and the method of course is main, but it has to have a specific signature. Its signature is public static void main, one argument, the formal argument name is args, and args is an array of string objects. And if the Java virtual machine sees such a method, it will load the class into memory and start to run it. This is about as close as Java gets to a standalone exe. The reason why we created the main method was twofold. The first purpose was to demonstrate that our model is independent of any view class or main activity class. So this can run outside of an Android application, outside of a GUI application, outside of a Java Server Faces application. Java Server Faces is Java on the server end. So it shows that it satisfies the model, the acid test, pardon me, that all models must be independent of their view. The other purpose is to demonstrate that the implementation of Shannon's formula was done correctly in our model class. So let's go ahead and run our Shannon's Theorem model as a standalone application. And we see here, for a standard telephone line with a bandwidth of 3000 Hertz and a signal to noise ratio of 30 decibels, the computed maximum data rate for such a line is 29,901 bits per second. And that's what our calculator produced in the calculate MDR method. And that agrees with from the website that I showed you. So this is a good indicator that we've properly implemented the calculate MDR method according to Shannon's formula. I should also like to point out that notice what comes back from the calculate MDR method is all of these significant digits after the decimal point. This once again speaks to the MVC architecture. It's the view's responsibility to display the maximum data rate to the user. So in the case of our Android application, we did that to two significant digits. It was the view that made that decision, not the model. As it turns out, using main as a method to perform testing is okay, but there's better, more modern, improved ways to do that. The better way is to make use of a testing framework or a testing container. And a very popular testing container is JUnit. So let's go ahead and create a JUnit for our Android application for the purposes of testing. So file, new, and I'm going to go to the other. And I've expanded the Android file group here, and we're interested in an Android test project. And you can see the badge there has a JU for JUnit. We'll click next. The project name that we're going to create is going to be called Shannon's Theorem Test. And sort of by convention, what I do is I give the name of the project that I'm going to test, and then I append the word test. I'll accept the default location, click Next. The target project that I'm going to be testing is the Android project Shannon's Theorem. Go ahead and click Finish. And if we expand the Shannon's Theorem test project, we'll see it looks very similar to our Android Shannon's Theorem project, but there are some differences. Of course, this is going to be running our JUnit tests. So we have a package here, and we see the package name is org.herdleg.shannonstheorem.test. Your package name should be very similar, with the notable exception the username should be your own user ID. We also see that the package is empty, as indicated by the icon. We're about to change that. We're going to go New, Other, and this time we're going to go to the Java group, expand JUnit, and the one that I'm interested in is the JUnit test case. We could also make a test suite. The best way to think of a test suite is a collection of JUnit test cases. We're going to write our test case. Click Next. There are two versions of JUnit. There's the older JUnit version 3 and the newer JUnit 4. JUnit 4 supports annotations, which I'm in favor of, so that's the version we're going to select. The name of our class is going to be called Telephone Test, because we're going to test the standard telephone. Our superclass, it's not going to be extending from object, so please bear with me. Pay attention to the superclass that I'm about to enter. It's android.test. So that was the package. The class name that we're going to extend from is called Activity Instrumentation Test Case 2. So be very specific and pay attention to the name of the class and respect the capitalization. And then to end it, we go angle bracket main activity, angle bracket. Make sure the setup is selected. Go ahead and click Finish. Now we're prompted from Eclipse. Our JUnit version 4 is not in our build path. Eclipse is prompting us to add it. We'll accept that, sure. And there's our telephone test. I'm going to organize this a little better. And so we have some errors already. So let's start to deal with the imports. The first one deals with the extension. This is the first time we've seen these angle brackets, and this is a generic. And when I do a mouse over, I get a hint that we can import the main activity from my Shannon's Theorem Android project. I'm going to go ahead and fix that import. We have another one here for the telephone test. The constructor was not created. So we're going to create a no argument constructor. So that's public telephone test. And we'll say super. And we're going to pass the main activity dot class. In other words, what we're saying, to conduct the telephone test, I want you to load the main activity class defined in the Shannon's Theorem Android project. Recall the main activity is our presentation tier. Let's go to the setup method. And for the setup, we're going to get a reference to the main activity. And we'll say this.getActivity. And then once we have the main activity, we can assign that to the maximum data rate. And this will be our text view. This is the output for the MDR. And we'll ask our main activity to look it up by ID. And we'll call our R class. And that's going to be R.ID.MDR. Text view. So we have some errors here. Let's go and correct them. The one I'll do a mouse over for the MDR. I have the option to create as a local variable, which won't help me. Instead, I'm going to create a field or instance variable. So we'll go ahead and do that. So we see that Eclipse was very nice to help me out. It added an instance variable with an access modifier private of type text view. We need to bring the import in for the text view. And now we have a problem with the R class. We cannot find ID. Turns out there is an R class in the test project, but I need to refer to the R class in the Shannon's Theorem Android project. So I'm going to do something that you have not seen me do before. I'm going to do a manual import statement. So that's import, and it's org.herdleg. And what I want is this one, and I'm going to backspace.r, and that will import the R class found in my Shannon's theorem. This was generated, and it's under org.herdlake Shannon's theorem. There's the R class. That's what I need to import. So far, so good. We have a reference to the MDR. So we're going to actually, this is the setup, as we can see by the annotation. Before we conduct the test, we perform a setup. We get a reference to the activity. And then from the reference in the activity, we get a reference to the maximum data rate text view. So let's go to test. I'm going to rename this to be, I'll get the mouse out of the way, test telephone. And what I'm going to do here is some sequences, some methods rather, that are going to simulate key presses. So there's a method called sendKeys. This has the effect of sending the digits 3000 space enter. So this, and let's put a comment here, enter 3000 hertz for the bandwidth. Cool. Now we're going to enter 30 decibels for the signal to noise ratio. We'll go sendKeys 30 enter. And then we're going to press the calculate MDR button. And for that, we'll just say sendKeys, and we'll say enter. And now we can assert the following statement. Assert equals. I'm making a statement of fact. I have the claim, I make the claim that the literal string maximum data rate is 29901. 0.68 bits per second. And when I compare that string to the mdr.getText.toString, this is what I predict the maximum data rate string should be, and I'm asserting that is equal to the one from the activity. So let's go ahead and save. So we do have a warning here, and we're going to remove this import. See if that removes our warning. That's correct. Great. So now I'm ready to run my test. So I'm going to right click and run as. And now I'm going to run my Shannon's Theorem test project as an Android JUnit test. So go ahead and do that. And we can see here that a new view has opened up. It's the JUnit. Actually, I'm going to bring this back a little bit. So we see that there was one run. There were no errors, there were no failures, and the failure trace, if there had been a failure, it would have been echoed here. I'm going to expand this, I'm going to expand this, and that's the test telephone that we just ran. Now I'm ready for my screenshot, so I'm going to bring up preview for that. Cancel. So there's preview, file, take a screenshot. And I'm going to do from window, and I'm going to take my screenshot here. And I'm going to save this as a telephone test. Actually, I'm going to put it to my desktop. The screenshot that you will take will be for a satellite television channel. I only did this as a reminder on how to take the screenshot and what to see. I wanted to see expanded. I'm going to come back to my test, and I'm going to show you what happens when a test fails. So I'm going to remove I'm going to change this number. I'm going to change this to be 0.00 bits per second. We'll save that. We'll go back to our JUnit and run the test again. And now we see that it failed. So we are given a hint that the failure occurred in test telephone. If I double click it, it'll bring me to the line. And it tells me here in the failure trace that I was expecting the maximum data rate to be 0.0 and it came back to be 29901.68. And that's why the test failed. That concludes this video. You now know how to run the JUnit for Android testing projects, and I encourage you to follow a test-driven process. When we go to the Applied Project course, one of my goals for you is to follow a agile methodology, and that's going to focus on test-driven. Goodbye.